This is Mike from Minimal 3DP, and today I'm continuing work on my Voron 2.4 Pro Plus. So let's go ahead and get started. So for anybody that's been following along with my series, I've been working on this Voron for what seems like forever. I've been doing these videos basically in around 20 to 40 minute chunks. And it just turns out putting together a Voron is complicated and there's a lot to do. So with that being said, today I'm starting on the electronics. So I have the manual called up in front of me. And as I normally do, I'm just going to page through this and it's really looking like I just need to figure out what parts I need based on the board I'm using and the power supply and just figure all this out. Most of this does not look really that hard, complicated. I just need to go through and look at everything and we should be able to set this up. I mean, the biggest problem I think I have is again, just figuring out exactly what I do have and then going through all the documentation. I've switched over to my browser. And if you remember when we initially started this, it looks like we have some different wire diagrams we need to look at for this model from FormBot. I'm just looking at this, seeing how I need to set this up. I guess the first thing we need to do is let me download this diagram so we can get it open. Ah, there we go. You just zoom in on it. I'm looking at the jumpers to make sure how things are set up. I have, here's for the tap. So that's actually on the tap. That would have been helpful last week when I was working on that. Now, the one thing I'm noticing is I'm probably going to have to turn the pin rails. So I put these in the wrong way. Let me switch over and we'll take a look at the tripod camera. So right now, these are perpendicular to the bed extrusions. We look back at the instructions here in this small note. It looks like I'm actually going to have to change the direction those are pointing. So they actually should be parallel to the bed extrusion. Instead of the direction I have them, they should be up and down. And I should have remembered this, but somebody did comment when I was putting this together to be careful about the DIN rails. And they did mention something about the direction of the DINs, that it was real easy to put them in wrong. And I didn't understand what they were saying. I thought, wow, let me just wait till I get to this point. But let me pause for a second. I'm going to just reorient these. And I'm not reorienting the printer. I'm just going to reorient the DIN rails. And then we'll take a quick look. So as you can see, I have those DIN rails reoriented. And so for my next step, let me start pulling out the electronics. And if we go over, let's just show you this. So here is the electronics, just a rendering of the mounted on the DIN rail. There's another rendering. And what it is these are clips that'll go on the bottom of the electronics and then snap onto the DIN rail. So the DIN rail fits right in this area here. So what I need to start doing is pulling out those electronics and figuring out exactly what all I have. I mean, I'm looking right now and this is steps for Raspberry Pi. I don't have a Raspberry Pi, I have a CB1. So let me get out all the electronics and then we'll start looking for these clips. And we'll start screwing them in and placing everything on the DIN rail. I should say that the awesome thing about these clips is we'll be able to move the electronics around so we can basically orient things and fix things so the wiring is how we need it. So let me get the electronics out and I'll be right back. Now I've pulled out the power supply and I'm noticing a couple things. One, this is a 200, which may be a little underpowered, but that's what it came with, so that's what we're going to go with. Now, I'm also noticing it's on 230 volts on the US. This needs to be on 115. We're going to change that. So now, as you can see, it's on 115. I'm big on checking that now because over this past week, I help somebody set up a K1 printer, couldn't figure out why it kept rebooting every time we tried to print, and it turned out there was our culprit. So switching that and printer worked fine. But for a little bit there, I thought I was going to have to ship back a K1 for somebody. So we're starting with the power supply. And let me find the printed parts and we'll get that hooked on the bottom here so we can mount it with our DIN rails. So I found all my DIN rail hookups and I'm noticing this is pretty nice. It actually has what this actually goes to. So I just need to find the two for the power supply and the rest. Let me see if they are labeled. Some of these aren't labeled. I'll have to figure out what they're to. But that's pretty simple. And then here's the one for the, I'm sure this is for the board. So we're going to start right now with the power supply. Let me switch over to the directions and we'll take a look. So I have my M46s out. So let's open these up. I think I'm going to need multiples of these. Let's get out four. And get my driver ready. And this should go something like this, like that. And then if I push this, that'll help me release it from the DIN rail. I'm going to orient it like that. So let's just get these screwed in. I'm going to try to orient both these the same way. That way, if I need to unmount this, I can just push the buttons on both sides and they're both on the same side. This again is real, real easy to set these in. And this DIN rail setup is very similar to the Mercury one when I built that. That's set up and that's actually looking good. Let me do a quick test to make sure this snaps in and I'm snapping it into the DIN rail, and it's a little hard to get on there, so I might have to mess around with this just a tiny little bit, but I think it's all right for right now. I'm just going to set that aside, and let's get the next piece put together. I decided to make a change. I have these clips that came with the Voron kit, and I found them they're really hard to get on and off. Now, I have these clips that are from the Mercury 1 kit. So I went ahead and reprinted these. And these slip on and off really easily. They hold pretty tight. So what I'm going to do is just change this right now. And I can, like I said, barely get these on. And I don't see the point in basically wrestling these. And if I have to move things around, I'd rather them come on and off fairly easily. So, just going to change these out. And as I said, this is significantly, these are significantly easier to get on and off. Let me get these mounted and then I'll come right back. Okay, so I have these mounted and what I'll do is let me switch where the camera's at and so we can take a look at how these just come on and off. Yeah, so we're looking at the bottom of the printer. And here is my power supply. And what I do is I take this side, put this over here, push it in, and you can hear a click. Now I can actually pull little tabs here and push those down and that gets it loose. I think I actually need this facing this direction. So again, it just clicks right in. And as you can see, it's pretty secure. So I can just very easily move that. And like I said, the ones I had just didn't feel very loose. And they're the ones that come with the Voron kit. I really like these from the Mercury 1 kit, much, much better. So I recommend these over the Voron design. And also I should point out, I have the same ones for the motherboard. They also, I have the SSR, and according to the directions for the SSR, this should come with a piece that lets you mount it. It does not. So I just printed the piece from the Mercury One kit. Again, that gets me what I need. And so let me continue to mount these on here. And as I said, I may wind up moving these around, but for right now, that just gets me started. I went ahead and switched back over to my desk. As you can see, I do have the connectors on the bottom of my mana board, but I want to, while this is right side up, change some stuff. I need to put on some jumpers for the steppers. I also need to put on the CB1. And then I need to check, I think, just the rest of the jumpers here and just make sure there's nothing I'm missing. That being said, let's get the jumpers out. And I think I'm going to pull out the instructions as well so we can take a look. I've gone ahead and changed how I oriented my board. I want to have this oriented exactly as it is in the directions. As you can see, let's get it where you can see. It's over. And let me add the instructions to the screen. Or better yet, let's look at the directions. You can see all these little yellow marks are jumpers. And so put that up here in the corner. Arrange that so you can see. Now, this comes with a huge bag of jumpers. And I'm just looking at these. These all look as if they're the same size. So let me see. I have this little plastic container here. Let me dump these out into there. Yeah, those are all the same. At least I believe they are. Looks like I need these in the second spot here in the red. I got my forceps right here. So hold that. And see if we can get this inserted. I'm already having some issues here. Okay. The first one in, and I'm going to put this for all these steppers, get those all in, and then I'm putting jumpers up in here too. Let's see if we can slip those on. And like I said, I'm not sure what these jumpers are doing. I might have to look at the manual. It's just funny, there's a ton of jumpers. From what I can see, it doesn't look like I need to set any jumpers in the middle of the board, which is good. I'm going to look at this real carefully. Now, the one thing I'm not sure of is it's showing the wiring of the display, but I think that's actually going to wind up being a future step. Let's get all these in. Now, I feel like I'm actually getting towards the end here. For this, anybody that's stuck with me throughout this series, I think I can't even remember how many videos we're up to now. 13, maybe 14. Yeah, so it looks like I have all the jumpers. So let's look at the directions a little bit more here. I think we're okay. Now, it's showing the filter power inlet, but I don't see that board. I'll have to look through everything, see if I can figure out where that's going. So, looking at this, like I said, I'm going to have to figure out where we're going here. Next thing I'm going to do real quickly is let's insert the CB1 here so you can see me do it, and then we'll just mount this in the case. Okay, so I did find the filter connection. I just missed it. Put that aside. Now that already has one of the connectors that I don't like on the bottom. I guess I'll just have to run with this. Also have to figure out how I'm going to mess with this. how we need to get this oriented. We'll figure it out. So let's just put that aside. I have my CB1 here. So heat sink with the CB1, so that's really good. I wasn't sure it had one. And so here is the CB1 itself. And that's going to be oriented like this. That is clicked in. That's clicked in place. Let me close my... I have two ways of doing the heatsink. There's a piece of adhesive I can put here and then basically just stick the heatsink to it. Or I can screw the heatsink in. Now, in my case, I'm going to screw the heatsink in. So let me screw this in. There's four screws and need to get the correct driver for these because it's going to be small. And this is a H1.5. Again, very small. Just going to tighten it a little bit. I'm not really buckling this down. And I just do two corners, diagonals. And now I've run a CB1 before without the heatsink and it was all right. But I think it's on this machine, I really want this to be totally right. So we'll just keep the heatsink on. Now, one of the things that was on the Mercury 1 is there was actually a fan mount. So I could mount a fan in the case to blow across this. So I don't know if the Voron has that or not, but that's a change I might make. Now, looks like everything's on there. Oh, one more thing we need to do is let's go ahead and get those stepper motors in there. So I have my EMC 2209s. And let me get rid of the CB1 box. Really need to start cleaning off my desk here. I mean, this is my own fault. I'm a bit sloppy. And I keep just pulling things out and setting them down. So this comes with six motors. And what I'm going to do is I'm basically going red to red, black to black. I'm just going to put these in without heat sinks. And I will add the heat sinks after I have these installed. Now, I'm looking at this because it looks like I'm only going to need to do this. So I want motor 1, 2, 3. I'm going to skip. I'm not doing this one. Okay. See how I'm doing it. Basically, I want all these steppers in a row here. We want all those in. And then what we're going to do is we'll skip one slot here when we actually plug the steppers in. Because we want each of the steppers to be totally independent. I have those installed. Let's just look at this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That should be right. Now I'm just going to take the heat sinks and place those on like so, right on the gold area. And let me just do that off camera. You don't need to see me do that. And then we'll proceed. So as you can see, I have the heat sinks on. So that's looking good. And let me see what I need to do next. So I'm just thinking about this, and I think I'll have to rearrange some things in the bottom of the printer. But for right now, I think everything's correct here. I need to find the SD card, and I'll insert that. That way, it's already in there. Oh, wait a minute. Before I do that, I'll actually have to install everything on the SD card, but I'm going to install and do all the wiring before I mess with that. So I'll wait on that for probably another video. Now, as you can see, I have everything mounted on the bottom of the printer. this is the back, this is the front. I believe I'm going to have to put the power switch over here, but I'm not quite sure yet. I'm also not sure about the placement of the board. I might have to slide it up simply because I don't have enough cord for the screens. So I'm not quite sure yet how this is going to need to be oriented. So right now I'm leaving it down here because it's going to have to go into the solid state relay, but I might wind up pushing this around a little bit depending on how I have to orient this. They come on and off real easily, so I'm not particularly worried about it. So that's easy enough. The everything, I think, is mounted correctly. This is the filter board. Now, it looks like the actual power outlet's going to run into here. And that's at least the way I'm interpreting things. Right now, I'm having a little bit of trouble interpreting the directions, mainly because looking at two different sets, both Voron and then Form Bots. But so far, this is how I have it mounted. I'm not going to do the actual wiring tonight because this just takes me a lot longer than I planned. But right now, we have everything mounted on the bottom of the printer. And I'm going to pause here, and then next time we'll come back and keep going. I want to thank you for your time. If you have any questions or comments, please post them below. I look forward to talking to you again soon. Bye. This is Mike again. If you're having trouble with your 3D printer, I'm putting a link in the video description of how you can schedule a 15-minute consult with me. I'm more than happy to sit down with you, see if we can figure out what the problem is, see if we can get your printer rolling. Also, if you would like to support the channel, I've enabled memberships, and so for a small monthly contribution, you can help support my work. Now, ideally, what I'm going to do is use any money, and same for the advertising I get for the channel, I'm going to use that to buy more 3D printers and more equipment and more technology that I could use here on the channel. If you have any questions or comments, please post them below, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.